Hello designers and welcome back to another Affinity Designer tutorial. Today I will show you how to make an isometric cube with rounded corners and soft edges. So we'll go from something that looks like this and turn it into this and then create something that looks like this. Let's jump right in. Okay, I'll just run through a few of my settings in case you want to follow along. I have my snapping turned on. Here's some of the boxes I have ticked. Document setup, I'm working with 1920 by 1080 pixels document. Okay, the next thing we're going to want to do is head up to View, go down to Studio, down again to Isometric, and click on that. This isometric panel has popped up. Click on Grid Settings, and I've just chosen 64 by 32 pixel isometric with planes. You can press Close on that. Click on Top in the current plane mode, and Edit in Plane, and use the Rectangle tool, which is shortcut M. Okay, let's activate our grid so that we can see it on screen. So I'm going to press Command and single quotation mark. The shortcut is down there in the bottom left. Okay, let's zoom in on the document and draw on one of these squares here. So I'm just going to click and drag down whilst holding Shift to keep it a perfect square. And I'm going to choose a light color like this from the Colors tab up here. And click Side. Zoom in a little bit more. And just press Escape to deselect the last shape we've drawn. And click down and drag again until it snaps into place. And we'll make this slightly darker. Okay, press V for the Move tool, which is your arrow up here. And press Command and J because we're going to duplicate this. In the Layers panel, you can see there's two of these now. Head up to the Transform tools and click on Flip Horizontal. Click and drag that out and place it until it snaps into place. And let's make this a little bit lighter than that. Somewhere like that. Okay, the next thing we're going to want to do is draw a shape around this whole cube here. So I'm going to do that with a pen tool. It's over here. Click on it, or shortcut is P. And we're just going to click on each corner until we've gone around the full cube. So 1, 2, 3, you get the gist of it. Okay, we have our new shape. Let's choose a color for that. Okay, you can see it here in the Layers panel. So drag that down to the bottom layer, and you can see the three shapes we created before. Select all of these shapes. So click on the first one, hold down Shift, click on the last one, and we're going to drag this down and to the right, and they're going to be clipped inside of that large shape we just made. So now they're all nested nicely in here. The next thing I want you to do is head on up to the corner tool and click on that. And click and drag over all of the nodes. You can see they're all selected now. And click on one of the nodes, anyone, and drag downwards until you start seeing the sharp edges being rounded off. Okay, so I think about here I'm happy with. And click on Bake Corners. Now I'll just click on the Move tool, V, and I'll just deactivate the grid, Command single quotation mark. So now we have the rounded corners, but we still have the sharp edges. How are we going to smooth this off? Well, click on the Layers panel and choose all of the child layers. Then go down to the Layer Effects, click on that, and head up to Gaussian Blur. You'll see where it says Radius. You just click and drag this slider across until you're happy with the result. I'll just move this to the side a little bit. And I'm happy with something like that. So before I press Close, I will press Scale with Object, and that will help if we're making it, scaling it up or down so it doesn't lose that style. Okay, we now have it. How would I change the color of this really quickly? Well, I'll make a duplicate. Select Command J to duplicate. I'll just drag this down. And with this selected, Layer Effects again, go to Color Overlay down here, and select the color you want. I'm going to go for some kind of blue color. Now head up to Blend Mode, where it says Blend, and click on Hue. Again, I'll press Scale with Object. I'm not sure if it matters here, but I'll press Close. And now we have a blue cube, and you can do that with any of the colors. Let me get rid of that. Now that's complete, let's make a stack of these and try and make it look really cool. I'll show you the first few steps I take, but from there I'll probably just speed it up as I'll just be repeating lots of actions. And just all I'll be doing is organizing the different layers in front or behind each other. Activate the grid, click on top, zoom out a little bit, Command J to duplicate that, and hold down Shift and click and drag outwards a little bit to about here. Okay, now I'm going to double tap on the top here so I can choose the child layer, and I'm just going to drag the eyedropper tool from up in the colors panel onto the side, and I'm going to activate that. Okay, I'll close that, and I'm just going to duplicate this a few times. So Command J, and I'm going to drag that out again until it snaps so it's all good spacing. And I'm going to press Command J a few times until I'm happy with that. Okay, I'll select this shape here, and I'm going to press Command J, and I'm going to click and drag up to around about here. And I'm just going to click the top and make that brighter. So I'll drag the eyedropper tool on there, and we've got the brightness on top now. So imagining the sun is around here, or the light source, and it's touching the top, and this bit would be the darkest because it's further away. For this color here, I'm just going to change the complete color of this one. So again, head to Effects, Color Overlay, Color, click on the blue, Normal, and we'll just go to Hue. And it's blue now. And the next thing we're going to want to do is select all of these shapes. So I'm going to select this one, and this one. And I'm going to group them, so Command G to group them. And I'm going to press Command J. I'm going to drag up like so. Okay, from this point, I'm just going to fast forward, so enjoy. Thanks a lot for watching. I hope you found that useful. If you haven't subscribed already, click subscribe and check out some of my other videos. Thank you very much, and see you on the next one.